Don't sports talk. Worldwide. What's news in the world of boxing? So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Yeah, I got it on. I'm playing it. Now, Oscar De La Hoya, Golden Boy Promotions, promoter of Canelo Alvarez, said, hey, the fight with Golovkin is definitely going to happen. That's pretty good news. It ain't happening until May, Cinco de Mayo. It's only bad news. But okay, we're going to get that fight. But I'm not surprised. I told you that that fight is definitely going to happen because neither one of these guys got anywhere else to go. The options are not as big or lucrative as them fighting each other because for some reason we continue to think this is the biggest fight in the middleweight division. For me personally, there's a whole lot of questions to be answered. Middleweight division was a little bit hollow, you know, say about a year and a half ago. There's things happening in the middleweight division if you're paying attention. Because those people who was trying to make sure that something was going down in the junior middleweight division, just not staying there, they coming up and following Canelo up and Gennady Golovkin because you obviously wasn't hearing them, you know, calling people out back then. Now we're in your division, making noise. So Golovkin and Canelo going to fight each other. Now, just as, you know, bad news to me because I think Golovkin, for example, is must-see TV. I'm watching Golovkin, no matter what he fight, where he fight, whatever, what time zone, or whatever. If Triple G fight, I'm watching it, period. Okay? I just don't agree with him being number one pound for pound or two or three because of actions that I've seen. You know, I'm going way back, I told you before, to the Andre Ward thing. I'm thinking a guy, you know, if you're the baddest dude, you're going to take that opportunity to be the most decorated fighter. I'm repeating myself, but okay. Those kind of things. Now waiting to fight 9 months, from September, well, to May, waiting on Canelo, because that's what he want to do. You know, when Golovkin can handle some other business. In the meantime, you know, it's just, you know, it's a suspect. But whatever, if Golovkin gonna wait out that long, okay. But I do think, you know, Daniel Jacobs will be there. That's something that, you know, I also consider suspect. When you have your hardest fight ever against a guy, Daniel Jacobs, when people, you know, you arguably lost that fight, you would want to readdress that. Most fighters do want to readdress somebody. Who do you think beat me? What? I got it. That's Floyd Mayweather, them type of cats. Anytime somebody even had an inkling that he lost a fight or was close, that dude's getting fought again, just to let you know. And Golovkin's team after the Daniel Jacobs fight was like, hey, we're not going to readdress that for 5 or 6 fights down the line. And for me, for a 35-year-old guy, I've said it before, that means we ain't trying to fight him. So that takes him out of the situation, basically, for a while. And that's funny to me. Then, you know, you got the mandatory guys. You're probably not going to want to fight your mandatory WBA. That's Jamal Charlo. You know, he could do that in the meantime. I don't see that happening. You know, the trainer already said, hey, he's going to earn something, you know, before he fight us. So that ain't going to happen. That's basically what you're saying, even though he was the champion at 154 coming up, and he's your mandatory. They don't seem like they're going to want to do that. Right? So the only one I see is this regular champion, Murata, who just beat Ndam. He might go to Japan and do that. That's the only thing I'm seeing. Because I do not see him fighting Devrachenko, his IBF mandatory challenger. Because if everybody knows, now I'm just saying, and I ain't playing, but the Ukraine bring the pain. It's plain, and I ain't insane. The Ukraine bring the pain, okay? And Derevchenko is another example of that. And he's the mandatory in the IBF, 11-0, and he took care of a guy, Toronto Johnson, who we thought basically was, you know, the goods. We thought he was going to be the hardest challenger for Golovkin. About 18 months, 2 years ago, he was the hardest one. We're like, well, Toriano Johnson, he's going to give him a little something-something. Well, Derevchenko took care of him pretty easily. He's from the Ukraine. And let's just be honest, Ukraine bring the pain. It is what it is. You know, we got Lomachenko right now. You know, some people heralding him as the best pound-for-pound fighter right now after 9-10 fights and a loss. You know, but they still consider him to be one of the best. Now, I ain't gonna, you know, we're not gonna just act like we didn't see the Klitschko brothers. We're not gonna act like we didn't see two heavyweight dudes from the same family
dominating heavyweight division, and we got the nerd to call it boring. Sour grapes. Ukraine bringing the pain. Again. All right? What? Alexander Usyk. We're going to act like we're not seeing the Super Series tournament in the cruiserweight division. The only division where the best are fighting the best right now in front of your eyes. Cruiserweight division. All of the best cruiserweights got together and got in this tournament. And Alexander Usyk is the favorite. Now, they had their first quarterfinals. He handled his business. Everybody handled his business. So after the first ones, you still got Usyk, Gassiev, and maybe Dordicus over there who people think could probably win this. We only got four left. Those are the three you think. I don't think people think Marius Bright is going to win this tournament. But let's just see. But Alexander Usyk is the favorite. It's a reason for that. Right? Let's not even forget Victor Postol. Right? In the 140-pound division. If it wasn't for Terrence Crawford, Victor Postol would be the bomb. He's only been beat by Terrence Crawford. And, you know, he can look right around. Hey, well, I'm standing in line with the rest of them that got beat. Ukraine bringing the pain. And in the light heavyweight division, you can act like, oh, you know, we don't know, you know, because Andre Ward's gone. You know, your boy, who's your boy? Adonis Stevenson won't fight nobody of significance. It won't happen. People still try to holler about Sergey Kovalev got the nerve to fight the dude who Sullivan Barrera beat Shabransky for a title, which is another travesty that we'll get to. I ain't talking about the Cubans right now, but I'm talking about the Ukrainians. Don't let me get on the Cubans, too, because they're getting ignored, too. But we know that. I always talk about that. But we're talking about Ukraine. It's a guy right there that people ain't talking about, but they should. Vucic. It's really Vucic, but it's a G on front of it. So let's get the G on there. Vucic. Better get to know him. Ukraine bringing the pain. And it's just really plain. So let's go on back, rewinding back over here to these middleweights. Dariushchenko, if I'm saying his name correctly. 11-0, Tiriano Johnson was very durable in this fight. You know, that scary durable, that durable that you don't want them to be when you got to save somebody from themselves type of durable, you know, where people get hurt. You know, people get hurt. Nick Blackwell was very durable and taking punches against Chris Eubank Jr., and he was in there and was coming forward and was still talking smack, not knowing that something can happen, you know. So durable is not always a good thing, taking these punches. So the beating Tiriano Johnson took with Dariushchenko was something to behold. He was taking a lot of punches, still coming forward, believing in himself, switching a southpaw, orthodox, doing everything to try to do something. But Dariushchenko ain't no joke. As simple as that. They call him the technician for a reason. Ukraine bringing the pain. So I don't think that it was no other options for Golovkin or Canelo. Because Canelo, in the basically, he can do what he wants. You know, he's got this Anthony Joshua thing, you know, where people just follow him no matter what. Don't ask him to do things. They don't have to do nothing because they're entitled. It's funny when I talk about Anthony Joshua, Deontay Wilder, and Joseph Parker, you know, people are accountants nowadays. You know, when they're fans, they want to see the best fights. Hey, my man deserved this because he's, you know, he got people coming to the stadiums. And he got this many Twitter followers and all that stuff that y'all care about other than the best fighting the best. You don't really care about that anymore. Well, Canelo's another example of that. You know, he wasn't the best of the 154-pound division. There were people there. You know, Demetrius Andrade, I always say the names anyway, Laura, and both Charlo brothers from Texas, and the two twins with titles, and no one wanted him to fight them, so he can fight at 155 and then go up to 160 fight Golovkin, which is okay. That's, you're doing something then. But he hadn't fought any 160-pounder before that. So when you ask Canelo is the best, what weight? Was he the best at 154? No, with a big resounding hell in front of it. And in 160-pound, he's not the best now. Although, believe me, I'm supremely impressed at his performance against Gennady Golovkin. It's supremely. But that doesn't mean that I think he beats Demetrius Andrade. That doesn't mean I think he beats Jamal Charlo. Right? That doesn't mean I think he beats Daniel Jacobs. You know? And I'm motivated Billy Joe Saunders. You know, these things have to be proven, but from the people that follow him, they don't. So the point is, him and Gennady Golovkin, they do need each other to have this fight. And that's why people are waiting. They'll wait 9 months and not fight any of these guys, because any of these guys is going to be a lot of risk and not that much reward. Although I say a reward is Daniel Jacobs because people know what time it is. Any one of these guys beat Daniel Jacobs convincingly, that's a reward for that. But you probably won't be getting as much money as you would get fighting each other. Right? So that's why everybody be waiting for that David Lemieux and who's Lemieux fighting? This important. Billy Joe Saunders for the WBO strap. People be waiting for that because that'll probably be the easy way out. And you can also have a title be a line. But the problem is, you're hoping that it's David Lemieux. Because if it's Billy Joe Saunders, he boxes his David Lemieux's ears off, he's going to be very confident, not easy to beat either. But it'll still probably be an easier touch to some of these other guys I mentioned. So my just saying is, I told you, bam, that fight is definitely going to happen. And those are the reasons why. Ukraine, bring the pain is one of them. Dome Sports Talk, worldwide. And I'm about to hear y'all.